the top of Anderson. Tracks all the way back in. Does. And he's lobbed in. But what a goal!
Inundated. So popular.
Literally was gonna say that.
Very early on the morning of the 25th of April 1915, long before sunrise, the Anzacs were ready to go into battle. They'd sailed from Egypt and now lay off the coast of Turkey in the darkness. They quietly climbed down the rope ladders and stepped into small rowboats. These were then towed as close as possible to the beach before the men rowed to the last part of the shore. They had practiced this many a times, but they were still nervous. They didn't know if the Turkish soldiers would be awake or how many there were. All they knew is once ashore, they had to go inland and as far from the beach as possible to make room for more men to land behind them. That was the plan. Suddenly, a bright flare went up. It turned the night into day. The Anzacs were still making their way to the shore when the machine guns and rifles opened up. The Anzacs jumped out of the boats and they were met with terrible gunfire. Turkish bullets were whizzing through the air like hail, and many were killed or injured in those first 3 hours. Some men didn't even get out of their boats before they were shot. Others who jumped out as they ran aground found the water was up to their shoulders. Some men drowned because their packs were too heavy or because they had never been taught to swim. Once ashore, the Anzacs became confused. They expected a flat beach, but instead were met by a cliff face. They had landed in the wrong place. They were scared, but determined. Clawing their way up the cliffs, they called out to their mates to follow. They dodged bullets and ran from sand dune to sand dune, always heading inland, always into unrelenting fire. At the end of the first day, 2,000 Anzacs lay dead. Against all odds, however, they held their ground. And so the spirit of Anzac was born. On that day, the Australian New Zealand Army Corps Anzac, as has become known now, received his baptism of fire and became one of the immortal names in history. We who gather here think of the comrades who went out to the battlefields in World War I, World War II, Korea, Malaya, Borneo, Vietnam, and various nations' peacekeeping, such as East Timor. And there's the wars in Iraq and Afghanistan, all that did not return. We wish to be worthy of their great sacrifice. Let us therefore dedicate ourselves to the service and the ideals of which they died. As the dawn has risen this morning and it's pierced through the night, let their memory inspire us to work to the coming and the new light in the dark places of the world.
Thank you.
Anderson. Tracks all the way back in. And he's lobbed